working.
Yeah.
You might not like, now you not like. You know I dealt with you.
My name is Chanel Elaine, and if you're new to the channel, welcome, welcome, welcome to the Coco family. And if you're returning, welcome back. As y'all can see, new hairstyle, who this? I did a cute little up pony, sleep my, you know, my hair down and everything. And I still got my edges to do. As y'all can tell, they are not done whatsoever. I'm going to wait to get them done since we're going out tonight. So, happy Cinco de Mayo to everyone. If you believe in it, if you don't, you know, it's fine. I just go enjoy a good time and eat some food, child. Spanish food. So, yeah, I am heading down now. I don't know if I'm going to put the previous clip in here or not, y'all. But basically, I went to this financial class. A whole bunch of, like, I don't want to say BS, but it is. It's just kind of trying to get you into, like, the pyramid scheme. And I'm not with that. And she's a very nice lady. It just wasn't for me. I just wasn't feel authenticity. I just felt like it went too good to be true. It kind of was like that. It's a financial advisory. It's like, I feel like you can learn that stuff through Google. You can learn that stuff through school. You can learn that stuff through YouTube. It's like, why do I need to pay to get into a course? No, if I'm going to start something, like, for me, it already gives red flags. I'm paying for something I'm not 100% sure on. So why wouldn't y'all say, okay, we give y'all the first month free, and if it's not for you, then it's not for you. But for me to just automatically pay, it's a win-lose situation. You're still going to get money out of me, and then I decide I no longer want to do it. I lose money, and I lose time. No, I'm getting older, and I'm to the point where time is super, super valuable for me. So, baby, that's one thing about it. I'm because she's like, what would it take for us to sign up today? I said, let me tell you something. One, I do not jump to make decisions, boo. I'm like, you can't just present me something because, oh, it's only a couple hundred dollars or a hundred and something dollars. No, ma'am. A hundred and something dollars is still a lot of money to come by. No, ma'am. So I just wasn't completely sold. And I'm the type of person, I'll sit there and hear you out, which is what I basically told I would. Because she's like, oh, come, it's free for the first class. And I was like, all right. She just kept calling me and hounding me. So I gave in and I was like, let me just go and hear it out. Nothing hurts to hear out a free program. I ain't going to sign no papers. So then she's like, oh, let me get your email. Let me get your phone. I was like, I said, next thing's going to be my address and all that. And I'm like, no. So it's just like when people move too fast for me, it weirds me out. It freaks me out because I'm like, you're telling me about this and you're talking about what does it take for me to sign up today? Everything sounds too good to be true, one. And for two, you're too persistent to try to get me to come to this thing on a Sunday at that. So I don't know. It was just giving red flags time 10 for me. I'm the type of person, I got to sit down, review something, see what the pros are for me. Does the pros outweigh the cons before I just agree to something? I don't know what she thought. She just thought, oh, let me just throw numbers in front of her. This sounds good. She's going to say yes. I'm like, I only took it out of kindness. All right, y'all. So clearly I ran out of space and I've been ranting this whole time. Y'all didn't even hear what I had to say. Anyways, basically she told the girl that I'm cool with at the office. She basically was like, oh, that's so bad of you, because she was like, oh, no. She told her the same thing and she was like, oh, no, I need to do my research. You can't tell somebody it's bad. Like, that's so bad of you. Like, why would you do that? That's so bad of you. You don't do that to somebody. Like, don't do that. If she says she want more time to research what you're telling her, she's doing her job, which is like me. Baby, I'm gonna hear you out, but please don't pressure me into anything. And like I said, the numbers just sounded too goddamn good to be true. And yeah, I didn't record none of that, y'all, but this is like the pamphlet, her card, and also this. So I'm just like, I don't know, y'all. She just rubbed me the wrong way. Like, she just was like, what's stopping us from signing up today? The fact that I haven't thought about this, the fact that it's new, the fact that everything sounds too good to be true. I was like, not Chanel. I don't make hasty decisions like that where my money gets tied up and stuff. No, ma'am. You can invest for free. You can save for free. Nah. So I'm like, I don't know what the freak she thought, but she wanted me to say yes immediately. No, baby. You got the wrong way. Got no contacts on, y'all, and like I said, I don't wear contacts for like 12 to 14 years, 2010 to 11 12 to 13 years. I don't wear contacts, so I done broke out my doggone glasses. This is the last one I got left. I had two pairs. I fell asleep, it was under my pillow, woke up broke. So I'm like, I'm just not used to having stuff on my face. It's everywhere but where it needs to be. So anyways, y'all, I'm heading down now to go get something to eat. I don't feel like you can go through Cinco de Mayo and not eat no Spanish food. That don't make no sense to me. So I want to get me some arroz con pollo y camarón, you know, all Lord, I start. Let me put my little 1-2 Spanish together. Anyways, no, though, y'all. For real, for real. Ooh, I should have went that way. Oh, shoot. All right, I'm going to have to cook through and go that way. But, yeah, y'all, I want to go get some, like, steak, beans, and rice. You know, a little tequila or a little reposado, something. Spanish today. I'm like, eat that and some like Mexican street corn. I love me some Mexican street corn, y'all. So there's that. I do need to book me an eye appointment so I can get some contacts for this thing. I'm not used to this on my face at all. So there's that, y'all. So hopefully we have a little good day ahead of us. I'm gonna just take y'all through. I ain't have too much plan. I just had a little financial class to go to. That lady took a whole hour and like 50 minutes of my time. I'm like, girl, I don't like to waste time. I'm at the age right now where time is very valuable to me. So please, I'm not about to sit. Don't waste my time. Because she wanted to keep going. I was like, I got stuff to do. It's Cinco de Mayo, baby. So she just overwhelmed me. I was like, Lainey, I'm overwhelmed. She's like, Mom, you good? I'm like, I'm overwhelmed, baby. And she just had too much knowledge. Everything seemed so simple. And when things seem so simple, that's when you need to question everything. So the financial class just sounded like a trap. And then, like, if like she tried to present it to where it wasn't coming off as, like, a life insurance plan. But then when I was like, this kind of sound like a life insurance, she was like, yeah, like a life insurance, but with a different company name, basically. Nah, baby. Fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, can't put the blame on you. Fool me 3 times, peace sign, load the chopper, let it rain on you. All right, but we're not going to do that part. But I'm going to learn from the one time, baby. I'm going to let her play with me the one time. Anyways, y'all, let me focus on the road. And this slobber right here on my chair, don't mind that, y'all. I had Gucci in here yesterday for his appointment. So, you know, he did very good, according to the lady. He bum rushed her real bad. When I'm not present, he turns up. But, you know, sometimes. He never met this lady before the last time he went to the vet. So, it makes sense. He's defensive. But he's not as defensive with the actual doctor. He's defensive with, like, the nurse helping. So, I don't know. But they say he, they had to put on a little gag on him. I was like, I ain't never had to do that to my baby. But I guess he snarled at her and turned up. And I'm like, you are poking him with a needle and giving him a shot. So what do you expect? Like, natural reactions, y'all. But they just make it seem like I'm just training him wrong. They just make it seem like I'm just doing too much. He just too protective. He just too aggressive. And I'm like, baby. So I had to record me a video with my mom. But when he see my mom, my daddy, he is a big old gushy mess. That boy don't bark. He don't do nothing. All he do is fall on the ground, jump up, love on them, grab their feet, roll on, get tummy rubs. That's all he do with my parents. So I'm like, he know us. Once he know you, he's a lover pup. But when he doesn't know you, it's a pit bull. And he's a, well, I got him from my friend's husband. He said he's a red-nosed pit bull. So, you know, they're naturally aggressive. Like, pits are naturally aggressive. You just got to tell them it's okay to interact with so-and-so. So I'm going to just do better by socializing him a little bit more at the pup part, the doggy part, and with like just humans in general. He don't got no problem with the family, and he don't got problem with people he's seen before. He just got problem because he don't know you and he's never seen you. So I guess he turned up a little too much, and every time they come talking about, you need to do this, you need to do that, he need behavioral help. And I'm like, no, he don't need behavioral help, because he doesn't do this with me. He does this with y'all. He don't know you. And my pup may be small, but baby, he will pick with a big dog. That's one thing about Gucci. He is not scared. I'm thinking like, oh, he's small. No, his bark be bigger than the big dogs. And I'm like, you know, they'll take your little butt and toss you. He don't care, baby. You just don't come close to mama at all. So that's that. But yeah, he done slobbered all over my seat. I got to clean my car out and stuff. He done, he wouldn't get in the crate. He wouldn't get in the car. Like, he just, I put him down a blanket. He was all over my seat. So, my whole car needed to be clean, y'all. So, just don't mind that. Anyways, y'all, we are super close. Hopefully, they're open. That's the first thing I should have did, was check to see if they're open. Second of all, let's hope we can get parking, because it is downtown. And I know they don't take, I don't think they take reservations. It's a walk-in is what she told me. It's usually 30 minutes to an hour. But hopefully, people aren't out at this time, like me. All right, y'all, so we're actually walking. I had to park way back there because, as y'all can see, it is filled everywhere. Okay, y'all, so that place right there, oh, let me zoom in right quick. That place right there that y'all see is like a little club area thing. It'd be like three floors of clubs. You go up the first floor, it's one music. You go up the next floor, it's another music. Third floor, another music. That's also the social house. That's also another little party spot. So we're having to walk. I'm gonna zoom out because it's a fall. I'm having to walk all the way to the restaurant, which I already seen it packed. So I already know because this is downtown. So I already know it's going to be packed. Say hi, Elena.
Hi. That's on my knee. College begin. Hop off a chick. Can I get rich? Can't do no more. And I get a check. You still gonna run on my pants and my chest. She's not a dress. Need up a mess.
All right, y'all. So the place that we're going to, let me make sure we can cross the street. Thank you for these cars. Come on, babe. We're gonna head down this way. Downtown. We get the place up top. Let's hope we can get an appointment, a thing, babe. Oh, I can't get it. Okay. All right. Let's go. Ooh. Hi. We're going to walk down this way and get scenery from outside. Kind of nervous. You mommy's date tonight?
What's the date?
Oh girl, let me fix your hair. I'm awesome. What's a date? You're my date. All right, y'all, this is my scene right now. We are actually sitting here waiting on Starbucks. We got two waters while we're out here chilling. I'm waiting for them. The wait is about 30 to 40 minutes inside and outside, so I opted to sit inside. So once they text me, y'all, I will keep y'all posted. Go, Lanny. Go, Lanny. Go, Lanny. Ten. You always saying the big number backwards. 9 out of 10. Why?
Because I didn't really like the corn.
She didn't like. Okay, y'all. So I'm gonna rate it a 9 out of 10 as well. I'm gonna tell y'all why. One, my favorite thing is the street corn. That I was like, oh, I'm gonna get y'all to see the street corn. They no longer have that. They have the corn now inside of a bowl. It's now a dip, not the actual corn. So she doesn't like it that way. She don't like all that stuff on it. She just like the little sauce and a little bit of cheese. This is like an actual dip. Like, it's very cheesy, as y'all can see, but I loved it. It was very flavorful, very good. So that's just that, y'all. I had 2 shrimp tacos and 1 steak taco. And the steak taco, I don't know what it is, but when they do steak and I bite down into like the grizzle part of the steak, it turns me off every time. And that's why I keep forgetting not to order steak tacos. I used to love their steak tacos, but then, I don't know, after a while it just became like eh to me. So their shrimp tacos though can get it. So I definitely give them a 9 out of 10. Anyways, y'all, as y'all can see, I'm just down here now walking to the car. And we're gonna head back. There's like the bridge over there and everything. But Elena, give me a hand, baby. So we're gonna end up heading back now to the car. Y'all, what's up? Your girl is completely dressed, and I'm actually heading out to the little gathering. You know, it's my first time going there, but I'm gonna meet up with some folks over there. So yeah, hopefully survive. You know, I didn't do too much with my dress. I just have on a cute little outing dress, some flats, and a purse to match, child. But we'll see what the vibes is giving. I'm almost there, and it started raining, y'all. Lord have mercy. And it's a Sunday. Ooh, child. And I gotta work tomorrow. All right, y'all, we should be out for a little bit though, but not too long, so I'm gonna keep y'all posted.
Yeah, yeah. No, no. Saw this was good. Sit back, ain't with a chit chat. She hopped on my side, she thought we was like that. Sorry, baby, I can cough, that is my bad. And she blind from the gram, that's so sad. Damn, she in love with me. Told her I can't love a trish. Keep it up, all.
Here we are at a cheer competition. As y'all can see, there's so much going on. Lenny's back there with my dad. We are, I don't want to say late, I'm on here on time, but I had to get some stuff situated for her, y'all. Whew, my glasses falling on my face. But anyways, y'all, yeah, this is how my Mother's Day weekend is starting. Look at this parking lot. Yep, so we have competitions today, and then we'll see what we got going on later. Y'all try to get snippets and stuff if I'm not too busy. As y'all know, I am a parent helper.
Yeah, they are. for the upgrade.
Are you still testing the phone? Let me give you a boost. I'm trying to let you up. Put you all on the news. We the crew that's on the loose. We'll upgrade you, catch a clue. Make you wanna roll with us, cause we ain't basic, we the truth. Fight the yard, say, let me upgrade.
Competitions. We came
second place.
They came second place out of 5 teams, y'all. So they did really, really good. They lost a couple points because when they did have the girls up, y'all would have seen that already. They weren't all the way lined up, so that little 1 or 2 point, you know, they got took off. But it's okay. They did pretty good. I'm super proud of them. And we are gonna be heading back for a 3-hour drive, so we'll keep y'all posted. Amy. I know that's right. All right, y'all, we're getting ready to go. So we're now at Chick-fil-A, the outside. I am grabbing myself and Elena and my daddy something to eat, and then we're going to head home, y'all. I'm so exhausted. My morning start at 6 a.m. I never told y'all that, but I got up, I basically worked, and got off work, went to cheer competition, as y'all could see, and then did some like last minute errands. Grabbed Lainey a last minute Mother's Day outfit to match, kind of sort of match my color wise, and grabbed my mom something for Mother's Day as well. And now I'm gonna get us some food and head home. I am exhausted, y'all. Being a mother ain't for the week, okay? One thing about it, two things for sure. You're gonna have to be a super mom when the time is right. And right now I'm a super mom. They had cheer competition. No one's gonna be tired the day before Mother's Day. It's crazy to me, but we made do. You know, it is what it is. I had to drive 3 hours there and 3 hours back. That's insane, but that's how competitions go. That's, you get what you sign up for. So we had to do that. So I'm now grabbing my food. Hey y'all, what's up? We are back. Happy Sunday to all. New hair, who it is? Okay, y'all can't really see, but OOTD me. Got my heels right here, and I got little Miss Mama next to me. Happy Mother's Day to all the mothers, if I haven't said it already. Hope y'all have a fantastic day. And right now, y'all, I'm a little late for church, but I'm heading in there. And yeah, baby, we're gonna see how the day goes. I'm gonna check in with y'all a little bit later. All right, y'all, I am out with Elena and my parents. We're getting ready to eat, y'all. Y'all probably can't hear me, but that's my food. That's my food. Y'all don't mind the mess, but we do have some crawfish and crab legs and some soup over here. Y'all, look, I got two Mother's Day cards, and this lovely basket, y'all, has nothing but fruits in there. I'm trying to spin it around if I can. Whew. Isn't this cute for Mother's Day? Oh, I'm grateful, y'all. All right, y'all. So my face is a little greasy. Don't mind that. I still got makeup on. Before I go to bed, I'm going to get this all situated. I was just in bed relaxing. So, y'all, it is technically the end of Sunday. It's after 12 now, so it's Monday. But Miss Elena decided to spend the night with grandparents. So, yeah, she's there. But I got the pup with me. So I was just up kind of just relaxing. I was so exhausted, y'all, after I finished eating. But I had a very good Mother's Day. I got taken out to dinner. As y'all could see, we did like a little family dinner. You know, I got cards. I got a fruit basket and some cash. So I'm thankful for that. You know, be the sentimental things for me and the words and the cards. So that'd be super sweet. So I felt extra, extra loved on today. And now I am exhausted and tired, y'all. So I'm gonna get myself situated. And I didn't get to go mini golfing with Lainey today, y'all. Well, it's technically after 12 yesterday for Sunday. So I'm gonna see if she's still up for it when I pick her up from school. If she still wants to do it, we'll just go ahead and do mini golfing, because I did promise her we were gonna do that on today. But my parents is exhausted. I was exhausted and she was exhausted, so it is what it is, but I'm gonna holler at y'all in a little bit. And this is the outside of the area. And yeah, let's go, y'all. Oh, so good. Let me see. Ooh. All right, y'all, this is the area. Isn't it super cute under here? And then we have this little practice course here. Okay. Tables out there. Come on, buddy, let's start. Ooh, Elena, if you do that, you might not get your ball back. Seriously? Yeah. Oh. Make a call, make a bong, 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 make a call, make a dream, make a bong, 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 your body, make a run, make a bong, 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 on the leg, get it. You know that I'm a dead drunk, a dead, fine, fine, no, bugger that, watch your love for like it, why not more, more than, your body, your body, check it, push it.
Oh, my men don't go home.
You're not playing in sand, period. Hey, y'all. Hey, so we're back home now. Did you have fun at mini golf?
Yes!
Okay, good. What about the, what is it called? The icy?
It was so good. I 10 out of 10.
10 out, she give it 10 out of 10. Well, for me, y'all, I don't know. The boys there was just giving me very much, like, weird vibes. So I just ended up throwing mine out, but that's another story for another day. But anyways, y'all, that concludes my Mother's Day vlog. I had so much fun and I enjoyed my baby. Thank you for going, mommy, and playing mini golf. And the pup is somewhere around here. But yeah, that's it, y'all. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and turn your post notification on so you'll be notified every time I post. And we're
out. Peace out, y'all.